And now I'm here with the CEO of Neptune Wellness, Jim Hamilton. Jim, welcome back.
Jim, the gyms are together once again, right?
Jim Square.
That's right.
Of course.
And you've remodeled since I've been here.
Well, you know, I did have some work done, and it's, you mean the
studio? That's right. Well, I noticed the drum set. Is it going to be the Today Show soon? Are you going to have a band
going? Well, actually, is going to be a live entertainment component.
Excellent.
Jimmy Kimmel meets Cannabis Online.
Good. I'm all in for that.
So. Excellent.
But thanks for having us back.
Of course. Yeah. Jim, on January 7th, you announced that you had received a license to process cannabis from Health Canada, kind of a key milestone given your business model. Yeah. Why don't you tell me the significance of all that?
Jim, it's a really great thing. As I was here, I think back in mid-December, we talked about convergence of commercial agreements with great companies like Canopy, the site readiness, and also the license, and to a degree the frustration that goes with the license. I think we came in around 19 or 20 months, which is not as good as some, but a lot better than others. But we're so happy to have it behind us, and now it's full speed ahead with commercialization.
Okay, so now how is that going to change the immediate sort of revenue picture for 2019 for Neptune going forward?
Well, I think maybe just to talk a little bit about the fundamentals, Jim, I think as I see them, we see them at Neptune for the business, I think to be in the extraction, purification, formulation side of the equation is a very powerful place to be. I think when you look at many developed markets, you see anywhere between 60 and 80% of the products based on some kind of extracted formulation. When you look at the pending legislation with Health Canada now, opening things up to topicals and concentrates and consumables, edibles, I mean, this is all great news. I think the demand profile domestically here in Canada will be quite robust. And I think when you look at the demand profile for extracts, not only the United States, but rest of the world, it would be very robust. For us, I mean, we've talked about 200 metric tons of extraction capability being online by the end of March, construction complete, et cetera. But I think it's important for your viewers to know that we also have the capacity to go to 6,000 tons in our facility. It's really a world-class, world-scale facility, and we're very excited by that. And we think the wind is behind our backs, and we're looking forward to 2019 in a really great way.
Yeah, you bet. Okay, so now the product focus for Neptune is going to be on wellness products, obviously, and that kind of puts you in a different place relative to the sale of THC.
Not really, Jim. I mean, I hate to say we're agnostic. We're actually very passionate, but our model is fundamentally B2B. Okay. And we will, and an example is our long-term contract with Canopy. I mean, the end use for the products that we work with Canopy will go into a variety of things, from medical to beverages. And so we will engage and work with companies, great companies, in any way that makes sense for them. We are a B2B company first and foremost.
So the core competency then of Neptune is the extraction and production of pharmaceutical and food grade cannabinoids as ingredients.
Yeah, I mean, we've been doing it for 20 years. I mean, we have a facility. I think you showed a video of it in our last segment with your group here.
We'll show it again.
Okay, but it's a CGMP food Health Canada food approved facility.
Right.
Now cannabis approved facility.
Sure.
And and that facility is there to collaborate, work, and support with great brands. And those brands clearly will be existing licensed producers, but I think as legislation and markets evolve in future, it will be food producers and other great marketers of products that we'll collaborate with and work with to help support their brands in this great new segment.
Sure, you bet. So in terms of the feedstock for your extracts, you are somewhat reliant or completely dependent upon the LP universe as it exists today.
You know, Jim, I think that's a really interesting question. When we first started talking about our model, a year and a half ago in New York, I remember the kind of emotion I received about not being a cultivator. My God, how can it be? We have no competence in cultivation. We're not cultivators. We think we're good partners for cultivators. But initially, we see ourselves collaborating, Jim, with LPs where we will help them and process their materials. And as the raw material landscape improves with new capacity coming online, I think that model may change a little bit, but initially that will be where it's at. And I think we also have to consider the whole CBD market here as well, Jim, and I know this is increasingly part of the conversation and recent announcements with Canopy, et cetera, but again, being wellness, nutrition products people, we're quite struck by the size of the CBD business right now in the United States. you know, it's greater than the vitamin E market today, and I think it's going to be greater than omega-3 fish oils very, very soon.
Wow.
And we will see demand through the CBD business development. I think that'll be quite striking, and is quite positive for not only marketers but also those in the extraction part of the equation.
So is it the game plan then for Neptune Wellness to be the brand that consumers see, or is it to white label the ingredients and let the brand take over?
Jim, our model is what it's always been, which is to support great marketers with the infrastructure to get them going. So we are a B2B company supporting other LPs in this business, and brands, by the way, who multinational brands who will choose to participate in this business in some way or fashion.
Right. The brand aspect is very interesting to me, because you've got all these, you know, you've got like Green Growth Brands, who's coming up with a pedigree of creating great brands and in-store experiences as destinations. And you've got the Tilray partnership with Authentic Brands, where they're actually going to write checks to the Authentic brands
right.
in the hopes that they actually are able to project Tilray's brand.
Yeah, look, Jim, I think a lot of us feel a little bit constrained within the regulatory frame that exists in Canada today. I think we should expect that, like a lot of businesses, with confidence and with societal acceptance, that will liberalize with time.
Mm-hmm.
But let's not get too myopic about Canada. This is a global phenomenon, and we will see global consumer brands at play here, I believe, over the long term. Hence the interest of, I think, many consumer product companies looking at this business right now. And I think ultimately, when we think about the vertical, if you will, of what is extraction and purification and formulation, I think what's really important there is there'll be a very robust demand, I think, over the near-term horizon because of all the reasons we discussed. But I think ultimately we're going to see differentiation be a huge driver in terms of the collaboration agreements and the alignments that exist that will come in the whole supply chain. So when I mean differentiation, I mean ultimately it's not enough to do extraction, but we have to look at delivery systems, we have to look at the clinical science, like we did with our omega-3 krill business.
Mm-hmm.
There is a great analogy here between nutrition products, Jim, in so much as the greatest margin and the greatest markets, in my experience, is where there's a conversation with the consumer. Mm-hmm. In this business, there's a conversation, whether that's a practitioner or whether that's at the retailer. And where there's a conversation, you can help those retailers be successful, or those practitioners, with differentiated delivery forms, greater bioavailability, clinical research, et cetera. We think, and that's what we're working on today, and our recent agreement and announcement with Lonza is an example of us executing against that.
Sure. As a non-cultivator, non-producer, you are never going to be held hostage to the idea of commodity price competition. And I think for the shareholders of Neptune, that's got to be a very bright and warm place to be relative to all of the other LPs who at some point are going to be competing on commodity price levels.
Look, I think healthy paranoia is essential to any business, Jim. I mean, economics ultimately trump. I think we can debate on the timeline. I think the demand profile for extracts, purification, formulation will be very robust in the near term, not only domestically but globally. And the differentiation, the separation, the winners and losers long term will be on the science and delivery forms, et cetera. And that's what we're committed to. So.
Well, sounds fantastic, Jim. Well, I can't tell you how excited I'm about 2019, both for you and for me. So thanks very much for joining me again. We'll come back to you very soon.
And Jim, thanks. Will we see the band next time?
Cross your fingers. Could be. It's taking a little while for all the equipment to arrive, and we don't even know if we have people who can play them yet. So we'll see.
Yeah, we'll work on it. I've got it. Jim, thank you very much.
Thank you.